Okay, yes. Let's talk about some of the people involved in the case. They called Martin Bashir, who is infamous for making that horrible documentary about Michael Jackson, and I believe he got scolded in the U.K. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Well, he was from the U.K., as I understand it. He charmed Michael Jackson into thinking that he would put together a very fair and balanced and honest documentary about him. And he knew Michael had a soft spot for Princess Diana. Michael always revered Princess Diana because he saw her as someone who could have just lived a comfortable life of royalty and instead had a conscience. She wanted to help children around the world, children in Africa who were starving, children who had AIDS, children in Eastern Europe who were the victim of landmines. And he revered Princess Diana. So Bashir manipulated Michael, in my opinion, and preyed on his soft spot for Princess Diana. And you use the word infamous. I think that's too kind a word. I think the man's scum.
There you go. That's better. Yes, but nevertheless, he was the first witness. And is it true that he tried to hide behind his own lawyer during the case?
Yes, he did. He was their first witness. He was a disaster for them. He had his high-priced lawyer from Los Angeles in the courtroom instructing him not to answer most of my questions. And he was hiding behind what is called a journalistic privilege, meaning that, you know, a journalist's sources don't have to be revealed. They're privileged. And there's some other nuances to that rule of law that allowed him, he thought, just to repeatedly hide. So I don't think he realized that it was turning off the jury when he kept refusing to answer questions. But by the way, a lot of people don't know this. When Michael passed away, I was in the middle of a jury trial in Los Angeles with Susan Yu. I called into my office, and one of the first messages I had was from Bashir, telling me that he never meant any harm, that he always admired me, and if I wanted to talk to him, he left his number, and of course, I never returned the call.
Really? So you got a message? That's how you really ultimately found out?
I was walking out of the courthouse and actually Randy Jackson's girlfriend was there and told me, and then some sheriffs at the entrance to the courthouse also told me. I was hoping it was just another rumor because Michael was always plagued by these crazy rumors, and I was hoping this was another one, and unfortunately I realized it was not, but I called up my office, and of course my message machine was full. But one of the first ones was Bashir, hoping I would talk to him and saying he never meant any harm, I'm a great guy, he's sorry for, you know, Michael's passing. And to me, it was just another manipulative ruse to try and get, you know, me to talk to him. And I assure you, I've never called him and never will.
Yes, and I know a lot of Michael Jackson fans appreciate that.